Good evening. The Transport Minister has made a once-and-for-all offer to the Rail Union in a bid to end months of industrial action. The government promising more than $200 million to fix the inner-city fleet. But the union is yet to agree to the deal, and Friday's major strike is still on.
October, December, February, June. A gruelling campaign of rail strikes over pay and safety concerns has left commuters riled up and running late.
I know, it's very frustrating.
With another major strike planned for Friday, the minister and the union boss came to the table. The government agreeing to the transport union's demands to modify the new intercity fleet of trains at a cost of around $260 million.
Am I happy about spending millions of dollars to modify what the safety regulator has said are perfectly good trains? Absolutely not. But the cost of this industrial action, the cost to the New South Wales economy, the inconvenience to the commuters has to be front of mind.
But the unions will wait to see the deal in writing before calling off the strike.
Our industrial action is still on. Our major action is on Friday.
There is no doubt about tomorrow's strike. Teachers in their thousands across public and Catholic schools won't be in classrooms. They'll be in protest, joining forces for the first time since the 1990s over what they say is too much work and lousy pay.
Tomorrow will be an historic day in New South Wales for all the wrong reasons. I can assure you that the last thing that teachers want to be doing is to be taking to the streets.
The Premier has come to the table with a 3% pay rise for public school teachers. The unions say a 5 to 7% increase would be a good start in addressing the teacher shortage.
There are many statistics teachers are using to justify tomorrow's drastic strike action. And here's another one. There are 1,906 unfilled teacher positions across the state this week. That's up more than 60% on this time last year.
The profession is falling apart. The people that are running the schools can't sustain it any longer.
Tomorrow, parents will have to pick up the slack. Most are on board.
Frustrating, but also fair enough. I mean, there's not much we can do about it.
Very supportive.
I think it's fair. I think teachers have a really hard job and they deserve better conditions, better pay.
For an update on the train disruption tomorrow, Lizzie Pearl joins me from North Sydney Station. Lizzie, what is expected?
Well, Pete, Transport for New South Wales has tonight confirmed services could be reduced tomorrow by up to 70%, 75% on Friday, warning of delays and cancellations. But, Pete, I've spoken to the union, which says commuters can expect minimal delays tomorrow and they'll make a decision on the government's offer and whether they'll call off that major strike action plan for Friday in the next 24 hours. Pete.
Lizzie, thank you.